हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ राकेश पांडे, सेकंड ईयर स्टूडेंट ऑफ सास इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ मैनेजमेंट स्टडीज़। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट केज डिस्टेंस फ्रेमवर्क, द टॉपिक ऑफ इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ केज डिस्टेंस फ्रेमवर्क। व्हाट इज केज फ्रेमवर्क? द केज डिस्टेंस फ्रेमवर्क इज़ अ टूल दैट कैन बी यूज्ड टू अनकवर इम्पॉर्टेंट डिफरेंसेस between various countries that companies should take into account when deciding on their strategy. The cage distance framework stands for cultural differences, A stands for administrative differences, G stands for geographical differences, and E stands for economic differences. The cage distance framework helps companies because it can evaluate countries and determine the distance between them. This does not only involve physical geographical distance but also figurative distance between various cultures, economies and working methods. The CAGE framework was developed by Mr. Pankaj Khemawat. He was convinced that one should look beyond mere sales potential and analyze the impact of distance. Here distance is composed of four varieties, one of which is geographical. The CAGE distance framework helps organizations to find out middle ground between measure they use and measure foreign organization use. It carefully analyzes cultural, administrative, geographical and economic forces, as well as determine how a comparable market would function in a different country. As a result, a company will be able to very effectively develop a unique range of products and services that perfectly match the local market conditions and structures. Large international companies carefully analyze local markets too, using this tool among others. For example, Google is currently having problems in China and Russia. Unilever has also developed strategies based on data from a country analysis, as opposed to, for example, a pest analysis. An example of this is Unilever's strategy in Africa. It introduced products in small volumes into the Nigerian market, among others, at a small price. This suddenly turned the poorest segment of the population in these countries into a market segment and an opportunity. When used properly, the CAGE distance framework helps companies gain easy access to potential growth opportunities in various international markets. Barrier and risk are part of international expansion too, but thanks to the framework's rational and analysis approach, selecting a country for expansion is not a gamble. The cultural differences between countries is the first and most important aspect of CAGE distance framework. Culture may be defined as a collection of values, norms, rules and convictions that form the behavior of people and organizations. Cultural differences in different countries is different language, different ethnicities, lack of ethnic network, lack of social network, different religion, lack of trust, different values and norms, how traditional is a country. For example, Google's difficulties in Russia and China. The cultural distance. Google's biggest problem in Russia seems to have been associated with a relatively different language. Administrative differences make up second aspect of CAGE framework. This mainly involves the historical, current legal and political differences between two countries. It helps the organization gauge whether these differences are an aid or an obstacle for the expansion strategy. Legislation and regulations can have serious effect for the trade practices between various countries. Corruption and trade agreements also fall under administrative differences. The most important administrative differences are lack of connection, lack of a common currency, lack of membership in international trade organization, political hostility. Google's difficulties in dealing with Chinese censorship reflect the difference between Chinese administrative and policy framework and those in its home country. The geographical differences is third element of CAGE framework and involves the physical aspect of the distance between two countries. These include differences such as their size, transport, infrastructures, climate differences, and other aspects. It's also an indication of the distance between two countries in kilometers. Globalization and digitization have made geographical differences a lot easier to bridge, especially thanks to factors like the internet, social media, and other technologies. Geographical differences between two countries may include physical distances, lack or presence of borders, different time zones, different in climate, different diseases, differences in environment, geographical size, geographical locations, means of transportation, means of communications, means of navigation, etc. Although Google products can be digitized, it had trouble adapting to Russia from afar and has had to set up offices there. The fourth difference is economic difference. It involves the differences between countries with regard to economic aspects such as income, purchasing power, distribution of wealth, but the gross domestic product. This may be a great obstacle for company, but it can also provide opportunities. For example, companies gladly make use of low wages labor in certain countries. Economic differences also involve natural resources, infrastructures, and organizational capacities. Economic differences includes differences between poor and rich, differences in cost, differences in quality, different natural resources, different financial means, differences in human resources, differences in knowledge and access to information. The underdevelopment of payment infrastructures in Russia has been another handicap for Google relative to local rivals. So, this is all from my side. Thank you so much, guys.